The notice should contain the particulars of accident and cause of accident. The compensation claim can be done within 2 years of the occurrence of accident or date of death. In case of occupational diseases, the period of 2 years is counted from the day the workman gives the notice or notice of disablement to his employer. When the commissioner receives an information about any kind of accident, then he may send a notice to the workman's employer asking the circumstances which led to the workman's death about deposition of compensation. Another is your medical examination. I would like to discuss about that kind of also provision done under this act. An injured workman who has submitted a notice shall present himself for the medical examination if the employer wants. Such an offer must be free of charges and within 3 days of the time at which service of notice has been effected. If a workman does not present himself for the medical examination, his right for compensation shall be suspended for the period of refusal and he will get full compensation only after he gives proper cause, reason for not presenting himself for medical examination. Another amendment or another provision is also made available in this act, and that is if a workman whose right to compensation has been suspended, if the person dies without presenting himself in front of the commissioner or medical officer, if he thinks fit, then commissioner may directly give that amount of compensation to the dependents of the deceased workman. So this right is secured only for such type of the cases, and for that cases only the commissioner is responsible for taking appropriate decisions and accordingly the justice is given. Now, we will think about the appointment of commissioner. The state government may appoint any person, the person should be official gazettee, to be commissioner for workman's compensation as per the mentioned notification. So, the commissioner must be here appointed by the government and the person should be here gazettee person. Another act I would like to talk with you or discuss with you, that is Minimum Wages Act. When the person is having his employment in any industry, then it is necessary at least to be aware about what is the provision is made under this act. Now, this Minimum Wages Act, it was enforced in 1948. This act has been amended in its local application by many states. For example, Bihar state, they did their amendment in this Minimum Wages Act. And for that purpose, that freedom is given to every state. Every state may contain different laws, different provisions under this Minimum Wages Act. Now, what is the objective? The objective of this Minimum Wages Act is here to prevent exploitation of workers or employees. This act aims at fixing the minimum wages which they must get. So, no any employee should get here injustice or minimum wages. So, for that purpose, this act was came into the existence. Now, important aspects of act which are I am going to discuss. This act lays down for the fixation of minimum time rate of wages, minimum piece rate, a guaranteed time rate and overtime rate for different occupations, classes of work for adults, for children, etc. Secondly, the minimum wage may consist of basic rate of wages and cost of living allowances. Cost of living allowance shall be computed by competent authorities such as director, labor bureau. Wage shall be paid in cash, it is expected. The act empowers the appropriate government to fix number of working hours in a day or weekly holiday as well as payment of overtime wages. All these things are discussed under this act. The employer is required to maintain registers and office records in a proper manner so that their hours can be calculated, their days can be calculated, and accordingly the wages can be given. The inspectors may be appointed to hear